Hello and welcome to the online module for risks and protections for Black girls' receipt of out-of-school suspensions. This module presents the results of a quantitative analysis of statewide data from the Minnesota Linking Information for Kids Minn-LInK project and a qualitative study of out-of-school suspensions among Black students aged 11 to 17. My name is Ndilimeke Nashandi. I am a PhD graduate research assistant. Our project team at the University of Minnesota School of Social Work includes Minhae, PhD candidate and graduate research assistant, Yang Ji Yoon, PhD graduate research assistant, Priscilla Gibson, professor in the School of Social Work, and Wendy Haight, professor and Gamble-Skopmore chair. We are grateful for the financial support of the Gamble-Skopmore Endowment and federal Title IV-E funding through the Minnesota Department of Human Services and the Center for Advanced Studies in Child Welfare. Overview of this module. This module has two parts. In part one, we will provide an overview of racial and gender disparities in out-of-school suspension rates in Minnesota. In part two, we will discuss Black girls' experiences with out-of-school suspensions in an urban school in the Midwest. In part three, we will discuss the implications for intervention. Learning objectives. This module has three learning objectives. We expect you to learn about 1. The significance of exploring Black girls' out-of-school suspension. 2. Black girls' self-awareness and consciousness concerning the intersection of racism and sexism. 3. Your own practice, especially intervention efforts, to effectively address the problem of racial disparities in out-of-school suspension. Now, why do child welfare workers need to learn about racial disparities in out-of-school suspensions? Suspensions can negatively affect children's well-being, health, and academic achievement. In Minnesota, Black students bear the brunt of these negative consequences, even though they are no more likely than other groups of students to engage in unsafe or rule-breaking behaviors at school. In other words, they are more harshly disciplined than white students for the same misbehaviors. Research shows that out-of-school suspensions as a standard practice to deter students' misbehavior is largely ineffective in deterring inappropriate behaviors. Although the suspension of Black boys has been an issue of concern, less attention has focused on Black girls. Nationally, Black boys are suspended at a rate 3 times higher than the rate for white boys, but Black girls are suspended at a rate 6 times higher than the rate for white girls. Now, to effectively address the persistent problem of racial disparities in out-of-school suspensions, it is important that we develop prevention and intervention efforts to work with caregivers and educators. Now, let's look at research sites and participants. In our research, we focused on children who received an out-of-school suspension. In part one, in order to examine whether there are racial and gender disparities in out-of-school suspension rates, we conducted quantitative analysis. This study used a secondary data set from the Minnesota Linking Information for Kids Minn-LInK project. The sample was 60,827 seventh graders enrolled in Minnesota public schools. We extracted a subsample of 3,326 of the seventh graders suspended in the academic year 2000 to 2010 for this study. Part 2. In order to explore the experiences of Black girls, we conducted a qualitative study. The site of this study was a large urban school in the Midwest. Black students who received an out-of-school suspension during the 2012-2013 school year were referred by school administrators. 11 parents and educators of all Black girls with suspensions also agreed to participate in the study. We will now turn to the methods section. To explore whether there are racial and gender disparities, the Minnesota Automated Reporting Student System, MARS, in academic year 2008 to 2009, was linked to child protection services. MARS was also linked to out-of-home placement records from DHS Social Service Information System and court records from the judicial branch. To explore Black girls' experiences, we audiotaped semi-structured and individual interviews conducted in a private location in participants' homes or schools. Interviews were conversation-like with story starters such as, "Tell me what happened to cause your suspension." In the case of parents, we asked, "Tell me what happened to cause your child's or your student's suspension." Interviews were transcribed verbatim and coded inductively. I will now present part 1, quantitative analysis results. To conduct a descriptive analysis of the quantitative results, we calculated the racial disproportionality indexes named RDI. RDI refers to the ratio of the proportion of suspended students from the subgroup and its proportion in the general population. For instance, an RDI of 4 indicates that this subgroup is represented in an out-of-school suspension at 4 times its rate in the general population. Now let's look at the receipt of out-of-school suspension in 2009. This table is presenting descriptive analysis results. Of the seventh graders, 5.5% received out-of-school suspensions in the academic year 2009, while the proportion of male and female students in the entire sample was similar. The majority of suspended students were male, which was 71.2%. Most students were white students, followed by Black, Hispanic, Native American, and Asian students. The proportion of receiving free or reduced price lunch was more than double of non-suspended students in suspended students. And attendance rate was higher in the non-suspended group than the suspended group. The proportion of participating in individualized education program was more than 3 times of the non-suspended group in the suspended group. The proportion of students with emotional and behavioral disabilities was much higher in suspended students. Academic achievement was more successful in non-suspended group than in suspended group. This table presents the disparity of out-of-school suspensions by race. You will see that the RDI of black students is 4 times that of other groups in the general population. Native American and Hispanic students are also overrepresented in out-of-school suspension, while white and Asian students are underrepresented. This table presents the disparity of out-of-school suspensions by race and gender. We can see in red that black students have the highest RDIs in both gender groups, namely for female black students 3.2 and for male black students 4.7. Based on this quantitative analysis results and the fact that there is relatively little previous research focused on black girls, we conducted a qualitative study to provide missing foundational data about black girls out of school suspension. Part 2 presents the results of how black girls and their parents describe the behaviors for which girls were suspended in contrast to educators by showing an exemplar for each result. I will read the result and give you time to read the exemplar on your own before I transition to the next slide. Result 1. Black girls' suspension result primarily from a breakdown in relationships with adults at school. Result 2. Black girls characterized educators as viewing them negatively and behaving towards them in ways discrepant with their self-perceptions and experiences in their communities. Result number 3. They described experiences of educators ignoring or minimizing their calls for help, especially around issues of verbal harassment as black girl drama. Result number 4. Black girls also described a policing of their physical appearance, expressiveness of their communications, and silencing of their voices. Result number 5. Black girls also describe protective factors such as parents, teachers, and a community of other black girls who encouraged positive behaviors. Result number 6. Black girls describe coping and resisting negative effects of out-of-school suspensions. I will read this one. One girl said, I should make sure like who I hang out with. If they are bad or good influence on me, I'm trying to stay away from them now because they were always getting conflicts with people and getting in trouble a lot. I think he, the educator, was disappointed in me because it was my first time also having an OSS. This part 3 presents our conclusions of the results and implications for interventions and practice work. From a black feminist perspective, these results suggest that black girls are pathologized in school in ways that undermine their psychosocial development and educational success. They also highlight black girls' self-awareness and critical consciousness concerning the intersection of racism and sexism and their resistance to it. These data are consistent with the literature indicating that black girls are subjected to a multiple forms of oppression. Now, what ways can child welfare agencies and professionals do to improve racial disparities? By focusing on black girls, support groups for girls to foster critical consciousness and promote positive peer support for school success. Increase educators' awareness of the intersection of race and gender on out-of-school suspension and decide how it affects their own practice and school policies. As agencies and professionals, we can create corners in schools where girls can have me time to debrief individually. We can also introduce school hours where students and educators can showcase diverse cultural heritage and create cultural awareness. This slide presents the references for our work. Congratulations! You have completed the module about risks and protections for black girls' receipt of out-of-school suspensions. Thank you and have a good day.